delicious can of soda, so...
Wait, stop! You're destroying the habitat of the phylum Bryozoa.
Wait, what is the phylum Bryozoa?
Well, phylum Bryozoa are simply just moss animals and sea mats that can be divided into three subphylums, the Phylactolemida, Stenolemida, and Gymnolemida. Each subphylum can be separated based on their basic structures and habitats that they live in. The first of the subphyla are Phylactolemida. They live exclusively in fresh water and have zooid monomorphism with a cylindrical shape. Stenolemida live in marine waters and have tubular or cylindrical zooids with polymorphism. And finally, Gymnolemida, which live in marine water and have flattened or cylindrical zooids and polymorphism as well. Stenolemida and Gymnolemida have fossils dating back to the Ordovician period, which was around 480 million years ago, and the Phylactolemida appear to be primitive but have limited fossil records.
Oh yeah, one interesting fact was stated on Aquatic News was about the way they feed. Each individual, or zooid, is enclosed in a sheath of tissue, the zoecium, that in many species secrete a rigid skeleton of calcium carbonate. Each zooid has a single opening, the orifice. Through this opening, the lophophore, arena-stylated tentacles centered on the mouth, protrudes to capture small food particles floating through the water. The lophophore can be retracted very rapidly by specialized retractor muscles, and the opening can be closed by a door like operculum, visible on some zooids.
Yeah, and also many bryozoa have both autozooids and heterozooids. The autozooids are used for feeding, and they capture the microorganisms from the water, whereas the heterozooids are non-feeding, and they are dependent on the autozooids for nutrients. Since bryozoa are immobile, they feed by filtering water through the lophophores and collecting microorganisms such as phytoplankton. These different zooids are unique to many bryozoa in comparison to other small marine organisms.
Wow, are those different zooids able to reproduce?
Yeah, bryozoa are able to reproduce asexually and sexually. They reproduce asexually by budding off new zooids as the colony grows and is the main way a colony expands in size. They reproduce sexually, like many other organisms, through sperm and ovaries. This produces larvae, which then grows into new zooids. Most bryozoans are hermaphroditic, which means individuals contain both ovaries and testes. If a piece of a colony breaks off, that piece will continue to grow and will form a new colony. If some bryozoan species, colonies largely die off in the winter and regenerate the following summer.
Wow, that's cool. I read online that bryozoa are protosomes, but I'm not too sure what that means. What is the difference between a proterosome and a deuterosome?
Well, actually, they are now considered protostomes, but they once were treated as deuterostomes. A protostome is an organism that develops the mouth before the anus, and a deuterostome is the exact opposite. This trait is shared amongst many other phylum, which then can be used to create a phylogenetic tree.
In the first phylogenetic tree, we are able to identify that this tree is based on the specific traits and characteristics of the different groups. A speciation event occurred, resulting in the multiple lineages. Our taxon, Bryozoa, has branched off early in the tree and does not have any sister taxa. In the second phylogenetic tree, we are able to conclude that this tree is based on the DNA or molecular makeup. DNA sequence analysis allows for a new interpretation of a phylogenetic tree, and according to the phylogeny of our taxa, it is evident that the Bryozoa, Porifera, and Cnidaria at the beginning of the tree, which gives rise to the following taxa. A recent journal article shows the traditional phylogeny tree A based on morphology and the phylogeny tree B, which depicts the molecular base phyla. The hypothesis of how the group originated was through protosome evolution, in which can be divided into two groups: the Actiosozoa and the Lophotrochozoa. The Lophophorates, a group that comprised of brachiopods, bryozoans, and phoronids, which all share a horseshoe-shaped feeding device made of ciliated tentacles, were considered basal deuterostomes. DNA, however, brought them within protostomes, and more specifically within the clade comprising of annelids and mollusca. The name Lophotrochozoa, for the whole clade uniting lophophore-bearing animals within those displaying the trochophore larva. It is possible that our trees generated in lab differ due to the fact that an error may have been made when classifying analogous instead of homology characteristics. These bryozoan fossils from the Topeka Limestone in Kansas were deposited during the Pennsylvanian subperiod about 3 million years ago and illustrate the branching and net-like forms of some of the bryozoan colonies. Bryozoans are sometimes confused with corals, another colonial group of animals within the phylum Cnidaria. Like corals, most protozoans secrete external skeletons made out of calcium carbonate, which form the framework of the colony. Bryozoans, however, are more complex organisms than corals and generally do not build reefs.